Hello all, welcome to lectures of design of electrical machines, and we are discussing about design of squirrel cage induction motor rotor. So this is part 2 of this particular topic, and in first part what we have covered is we have understood there might be different types of problems when we are going to choose wrongly number of stator and rotor slots. So those problems are related with first one is induction torques, which is called as crawling. Another one is synchronous torques, where motor may not start. So that typical part is called as related with synchronous torques, which is called as a cogging. And third problem which we may face, which is related with vibrations and noise. And in last lecture we have stopped at the point where we understood there might be two types of forces when you are going to have vibrations and noise in induction motors. One is low frequency varying forces, and another is forces which are having frequency 10 hertz to 10 kilohertz. Where in low frequency varying forces, you will observe your vibrations are getting transferred to structures. But in another types of forces, you may face issues related with acoustics. Acoustics is problems related with noise, so you may get humming or whistling. So now let us continue to understand somewhat more points related with vibrations and noise. So vibration torque generation, mathematically you can model with the help of two different formulae. One is, and this is by research, there is no proof kind of thing, but there are two types of formulae you can observe over here. One is difference between stator and rotor number of slots is plus minus 1 plus minus p, and another formula is difference between stator slots and rotor slots will be plus minus 2 plus minus p. So let me focus on this particular formula and let us understand what should be the value of P and what should not be the value of P. Okay, so let us take again example. Your number of stator slots are going to be 3PQS. So I am considering a three phase machine, and this is going to be your number of poles, and QS is nothing but as an integer. So now let us take example, and we can justify. If you take QS as an integer, how this SS is always even? Let me take example of 4-pole machine. So when you are having 4-pole machine, your number of stator slots are going to be like this, 3 into 4. So what is going to happen? 3 into 4 is 12. So you choose any integer for 12. Now like 12, if you choose 1, if you choose 2, if you choose 3, so all numbers you are going to get is always even. So that will be multiple of 12. Likewise, you choose 2, that will be multiple of 6. You choose 3, 3 you cannot choose for poles, because those are always even, like 2-pole, 4-pole. Like, that's why ultimately you will get this number of stator slots is always even. Now, if you put this even number in this particular formula, what you will get is there is restriction on rotor. Why? Because this number is going to be even, this number is also even. So what is going to be there? If you let's see what happens if you choose this number as a odd number. So rotor with odd numbers of slots are undesirable. Why? Because if this is going to be odd, you are going to satisfy this formula. So rotor with odd number of slots are undesirable from the point of view of vibrations and noise. So if you choose this one is definitely going to be even. So if this is odd, you will satisfy this formula and there will be vibration torque generation. Likewise, you can understand. Now, let us understand another effect where there might be some voltage ripples because of these harmonic fields. And this is very simple to understand. Ultimately, whatever happens in rotor, in induction motor, is effect of whatever happens in stator. Please understand. So if you are having some harmonic fields in stator, they will induce harmonic fields in the rotor. And very basic thing, likewise Lenz's law, these harmonic fields in the rotor are going to induce some back harmonic fields again in stator. So there will be rippling, and these ripples in will be observed in your terminal voltage, and additional iron losses will be there because of these voltage ripples. Now, once we understand typically four problems like cogging, your crawling, your vibrations and noise, and these voltage ripples, we have to focus on how to reduce these harmonic torques. So there might, there are some techniques to reduce harmonic torques, which we'll discuss one by one, out of which this particular technique, which I have star marked, we are going to see in detail because there is some mathematical proof for that. Now, first point, the simplest thing what you can do if you want to avoid harmonic torques, you can restrict those at a stator level. How you can restrict? You can focus on getting pure MMF. So stator winding MMF, only then you can get pure only when you can beacon the stator winding MMF harmonics. So what is the trick for that? There are some winding design modifications. So there is one type of winding which is called as a corded winding. You can use with integral number of slots per phase per pole. So this corded winding is very important word. You can understand what is the solution. If you use corded winding, you can avoid harmonic fields or harmonic torques in stator. Ultimately, if they are not in stator, they will not be induced in the rotor. That is the simplest thing. Now, another thing is there are two types of windings. You can either have a fractional slot winding or integral slot winding. So whenever fractional slots are there, they are bringing some asymmetry. When they are bringing asymmetry, there will be noise creation, and again that noise will be induced into rotor, and it's going to create some problems. So what is the another solution is, instead of solution, it's a kind of a design decision. You should always use integral slot winding. That is another thing. So what was first one? You should choose corded winding. Another one is integral slot winding. Third one, there is a different methodology, design modification, which is called as a skewing, which we are going to see in detail. So either in stator or in rotor, you can do skewing. But in India, typically skewing is done in rotor. So how it is done and what is the mathematical proof, we will see shortly. And last one is increase in air gap length. That is also the solution to you know, control your harmonic torques. But at the same time, we have already seen through some separate lecture related with air gaps, and there we have understood that if you increase air gap length, ultimately your magnetizing current is going to increase, which will make your power factor poor. So this kind of solution is all applicable only to those motors which are having high reliability, where larger air gap is affordable, and the reason is typically mechanical. So what are the solutions? I will just repeat to summarize. First solution is using corded winding. Second solution is to use integral winding and to avoid using fractional winding. Third solution is skewing, and fourth solution is we should increase the air gap length, but there are some parallel drawbacks to that. Before going ahead, just let me explain you with the help of some speed torque characteristics what may be the effect. So you can observe, this is very simple. I have already told you in last lecture, whenever you want to see the effects of these harmonic torques, you have to understand the speed torque characteristics of induction motor. So this is on x axis there is speed, and here my torque characteristic you can observe. So I'm just in a few seconds, I'll just take a review of this. So see this, when you are having fifth harmonic, you are having some backward rotation. This is negative cycle, this is positive cycle. So fifth and seventh, addition of this, it will disturb your overall torque characteristics, which should have been a smooth one. Okay, now these dips are observed. What is next? This we have already understood in my lecture part 1, so you can go through that. NS by 17, NS by 19. So ultimately these are the dips because of slot harmonics. You can understand. These diagrams are very important as far as your exam is concerned. They may ask you to draw these kind of things. Improper slot combination impact. So this also we have seen. So ultimately your speed torque characteristic is going to disturb. This example we have seen synchronous torques and synchronous crawling. We have seen the relative speed between stator and rotor. And ultimate effect will be you will observe your rotor speed is ns by 10. So there will be a crawling kind of effect because of your presence of ns by 17 and ns by 19. Okay, so in summary, let us understand what is our decision, what to choose, what not to choose, and then we will shift to our last point of this lecture, which is called as a skewing of induction motor rotor and squirrel cage induction motor rotor. So let us summarize. What are the different criteria which we have understood for stator and rotor number of slot selection? I'll just focus on these numbers. You can understand. See this. 15 to 15 to 30% is the criteria. So 15 to 30% you should not fall into. Either your increase number should be higher than 15 to 30% or lower than 15 to 30%. So satisfactory results are obtained when number of slot rotor slots is 15 to 30% either larger or smaller than the number of stator slots. That we have already seen in detail. Another thing is the difference between stator slots and rotor slots should not be equal to, these are the typical numbers, difference between. So SS minus SR should not be equal to P, 2P or 5P to avoid synchronous cusps. Okay, so third point is the difference between number of stator and rotor slots should not be equal to 3P to avoid three phase machines in order to avoid magnetic locking. So that's cogging. And last point is you should not have a difference like 1, 2 because of the formulae we have just seen, either P plus minus 1 or P plus minus 2. So in summary, and again, it should not be zero also. So you should not choose your number of stator slots equal to number of rotor slots, because if there is some common factor, you will face some issues. So 0 plus minus P plus minus 2P plus minus 3P plus minus 5P plus minus 1 plus minus 2 plus minus P plus minus 1 plus minus P plus minus 2. So in summary, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So there are 9 kind of criteria or restrictions you are having when you are going to design your induction motor rotor, squirrel cage induction motor rotor. Now let us understand our solution to avoid harmonic torques in squirrel cage induction motor in detail, which is called as a skewing. So what is done in skewing is there is modification in rotor bars and there is some angular modification. So it's a problem reduction. So there are different types of problems: vibrations, cogging and synchronous cusps. So with the help of this, what we are going to do, there should be some displacement of flux density, magnetic pulling and torque in time phase along with core length. So along with core length, you are going to displace your flux density, magnetic pull and torques so that you will get some better results. So what is the impact? You will be getting uniform torque, lesser noise, better voltage waveform, and that is what we are expecting. Please understand, just focus on C. This is ideal characteristic: uniform torque, no cusps, nothing, less noise and better voltage waveform. Your induction motor rotor will be ready. So how it is done? The bars must be skewed through two pitches. So that is important thing. What is two pitch? It will fall under alternate poles of same polarity. Please understand. So you are having NSN. So when you are doing it by two pitches, bars will fall under N and N. So bars will lie under alternate harmonic poles of same polarity, and it is achieved through angular shifts. Once you understand this, it is having some mathematical background behind, and which we will understand. Harmonic, consider it is a nth harmonic, so number of machine poles are P. So what will be your number of harmonic poles? It's a very simple concept, N into P. Now, when you are having these number of harmonic poles and you are having 360 degree angle, what will happen? Your angle between adjacent harmonic poles, you can imagine it's a induction motor, rotating part, and in that there will be presence of some harmonic poles like NP, number of harmonic poles are NP. So your angle dedicated to every harmonic pole will be 360 by NP. Now, what should be the angle of skew as per this criteria? Criteria D should be multiplied by 2 mechanically, because they are going to fall in alternate harmonic poles of same polarity. Bars will lie under alternate harmonic poles of same polarity. So it will be multiplied by 2. So it will be angle of skew will be 720 by NP, but which is mechanical. Now our duty is to convert this mechanical angle into electrical angle. How we can convert? Here I have given you basics of that. We are aware, very basic formula, theta m is equal to 2 theta e by p. So putting this here, multiplying by p by 2, we'll get ultimately 360 by n degree electrical, or 2 pi by n electrical radian. How you can ensure with the help of this your harmonics are getting reduced or your harmonic torques are getting reduced? Here is the proof. Now imagine your distribution factor is very important when you are designing induction motors. And now there will be two types of distribution factors, please understand. One is your fundamental distribution factor, and another is going to be your distribution factors because of presence of harmonics. So what is fundamental distribution factor? You are aware of the formula, sine theta by 2 divided by theta by 2. Now this theta is of angle of skewing. So sine theta sk by 2 divided by theta sk by 2, that is one which is very fundamental. Another one is distribution factor because of presence of harmonics. So for nth harmonic, you should just multiply that angle by n. So that will be kdn is equal to sine n theta by 2 divided by n theta by 2. You just put theta sk is equal to 2 pi by n, and what you will get is your kdn is going to equal to 0. Now once you get this one is 0, your phase spread is 2 pi, and your kdn, so distribution factor because of harmonics will be 0, and you will get very pure or a smooth torque speed characteristics for induction motor. Now imagine if rotor, so this is a general method, the rotor is generally skewed through one stator slot pitch. Okay, so what should be the angle? Considering number of stator slots, so theta sk will be pi p by ss, by only one pitch, only one pitch. So pi p divided by ss electrical radian. So there should not be any 2 pi angle. This should be pi into p divided by ss. So slot harmonics formula, we have seen it in last recorded lecture also. So this slot harmonics is nothing but n is equal to 2 into ss by p plus minus 1. Put this value n in your formula for distribution factor for harmonics, and this value theta sk, you will get in this formula, you will get to know ultimately you are going to get this one. So plus minus sine theta pi p by 2 ss divided by pi plus minus pi p by 2 ss. So this kdn will be equal to, I'll repeat, plus minus sine pi p by 2 ss divided by pi plus minus pi p by 2 ss. How to justify? Let us take one small example, a motor with 4 poles and 36 slots. So 4 poles, 36 slots will be having slot order harmonics as per our earlier discussion, either 17th or 19th. 19th will be forward, 17th will be backward. So if you put this formula, these numbers in this formula, will get for 19th harmonic, your distribution factor is going to be minus 0.052. For 17th harmonic, it's going to be 0.058. Now, you can observe here, your EMF induced owing to slot harmonic is drastically reduced, which is, there is a reduction 5 to 6% in magnitude. Okay, so here you can observe, even if you do skewing through one stator slot pitch, you are getting better results. Okay, but what are the effects of this? winding factor for the fundamental is going to decrease when you are doing skewing. Winding factor decreases, you are, you know, inviting some larger leakage flux, and when leakage flux increases, problems will start in induction motor. Again, it will impact your power factor and all. You are aware of basics. So what is the another point is, it lowers your overload capacity and power factor of the machine. That's true. You can refer my lecture of air gap. You will get somewhat more details related with this. So let us see how this skewing is done. So skewing of rotor bars, you can observe this. This is the angle of skewing. Okay, this is core. So ultimately air harmonics are going to be zero. It's a kind of a cancellation of harmonics, please understand. With the help of some modification in design, we are cancelling harmonics present in induction motor harmonic fields. So it will save your harmonic torques, and once save your rotor from harmonic torques. Once harmonic torques are cancelled, you will get a smooth speed torque characteristics. That is the thing. And here they have shown, so effect of skewing, you can observe this. When you are, have not done skewing, how you are getting your harmonic your speed torque with respect to speed, and this might, you must be knowing which one is a very pure fundamental speed torque characteristic, which is with skewing. Okay, so here I am concluding overall design of squirrel cage induction motor rotor. I'd like to summarize. We started understanding that if we choose wrongly stator and rotor number of slots, we may face some issues. Some of the issues are cocking, crawling, vibration and noise, and voltage ripples. So just to avoid that, we can have some solutions like using corded windings. Another one is, you can use integral number of slots instead of having fractional slots. Another one is skewing, and last one was here. I'm taking the reference of this one. Your last one was to increase the air gap length. So corded winding, integral slot pitch, skewing of either stator or rotor, or increase of air gap length. This will avoid bringing your harmonic torques in your squirrel cage induction motor rotor. Thank you.